Imagine you are building an e-commerce site with a lot of models like product, brand, and then category. So you know that with each model, in order to have database operations like create, read, update, and delete, you need to create an interface to handle that. Now, each interface is going to handle the create, read, update, and delete operation. That is even not the case. The implementation is where the problem is. You know, since you're having the same CRUD operation for each model, you need to repeat the same code in all the models that you're going to, or all the repositories that you're going to create, isn't it? Great. So that is the reason why we need to stop repeating this code by using a generic repository pattern. Maybe you might be asking, what is generic repository pattern? You know, it provides one size fit for all approach to CRUD operations by using generic. Think of it as a single set of CRUD methods that work with any type of model, whether it is product, it is brand, or it's category. It saves us from writing the same method repeatedly for different models. I do have a code created with the old approach, that is in having a separate interface and a separate implementation, although they are repetitive, but I have the same thing over there for product, category, and our brand. Let's have a look, then see how we can streamline this with the new repository pattern that I am talking about. So when you go to solution, you can see from here that I have a controller created. I have my data folder created, which contains the DB's context. I have my interfaces and I have my models. So these are the models that I do have: brand, category, and then product. In that, I have interfaces for each. So it has a repository for each, which talks about the CRUD. And I have the category repo. I have also the product. Now let's go to the implementation. This is a repository. From the brand, you can see that here I am taking three. And aside from that, I'm getting by ID, adding, updating, deleting, and adding, updating, and deleting, right? So we see from here, I have this function here working perfectly. Now, when you go to the category, I also having the same thing. The difference in here is I have the model change, but the context is the same. Now, look at the last one, that is a product repo. You can see it is also the same thing. So when you have a lot more than 3, 4, 5, 6 models, do we have to repeat this over and over again? No, you can use a generic to handle that. So let's see how we can streamline this using generic. So let's create a generic class, which is going to be an abstract class in the repositories folder. And let's try to streamline this. So that is what we need to do. When you check here, you can see we create this repository and we're going to pass in this the entity. Now we know that there's going to be a class, that is a model. A model is a class. Now in here, we're going to create our DB context. Now we're creating the variable here as an object, which is going to hold the value we're going to pass on through the constructor. So that is the reason why anytime that we inject this, we need to specify, we need to pass in the constructor. That's going to be assigned over here, and which we're going to be using it to save and perform the operations here. So you see we are adding, and here EF quite smart to set the entity type from the model coming in, and now get the data table and add it. After that, make a save. Do the same thing here. As you update, you save it, and now do the same thing. As you get by ID, return this model. And now delete is to find it. remove it, and also save it. This is the basic CRUD unit for all, and this is going to be using as a basis for all the models that we spoke about, talking about the product, the brand, and the category. So as we are done creating this, let's see how we can utilize this or use this in the various repositories. Let's go to solution. Now, in the implementation for the brand, all that I need to do here is to inherit from this brand, this repository, and I need to specify the brand. And seeing this takes in a constructor, I can just grab the constructor as a DB context. Then I'm going to paste it on here because this takes in this DB context. As soon as I do that, see what happens here. It's saying that, hey, you have something hidden. So kindly use a new keyword if you want to override that. We don't want to do it. So we can get rid of all this. You see, can get rid of all this. Now I left one over here because it is model specific. Have a look. We are taking three here. So we cannot add this because from this brand, we want to take only three out of them. Okay. So we cannot add this as a generic. Try to have a basis, a base for all. Whatever they're going to provide in the generic needs to be implemented by all. If you want to follow the CRUD or clean architecture principle. So keep that in mind. Okay. Now this DB context has a public protected variable, which is known as a DB context. And it's coming from as an instance of the constructor injection. So we can also use that DB context. And you can see we have issue solved. So we have able to streamline the brand repository, all these codes, we've removed them into one file. Well, maybe you might be saying, okay, it's not like we've done anything new. All that we've done here is to copy this code and then put it in there. Good. Well, it makes sense. But you're going to understand this better when you go to the category or the product. As for this, we are also going to streamline this again. So let's say repository. And here we pass in the category, pass in the context, and here we can use this DB context. And now also the same thing, let's get rid of all this. Now this tells you that, well, a generic is profitable, right? So we have also streamlined this. Instead of keeping all this code, we've removed everything. Now check the last one, that is a product. So we need to also do same with it. Let's also use this DB context here. And then we can also get rid of all this. So you see, we have been able to streamline this with our repository, which is generic. Great. Now, the next question is, how is it going to work? Are you sure this is going to work? Yes, it is. It will work. Now, before we run this, let me take you through the step that I did. If you're new to this, you can see from here, after creating this model and after creating the interfaces and creating implementation now with this generic, you need to go in there and register this in the program so you can create dependency injection, creating an interface, and I'm binding its implementation to it. Aside from doing that, I also added database, which is an SQLite. So I installed these packages in here. EFCall, SQLite, and tools, and I added Swashbuckle because you know that with .NET 9 it does not include Swashbuckle by default. So if you want to use Swashbuckle as what we've been doing since, then we can also install this package and configure the pipeline and the service. Go to program.cs file and you can see from here I am registering database connection in there. I am also adding Swashbuckle service. And after that, I am adding the middleware pipeline for the Swashbuckle. That is a swagger. And that is all. Now, when you are done with this, you go to your line settings. Default.9 project starts with weather forecast. You can check it from this properties folder, launch settings. You can see from here, it is starting from weather forecast. That is a launch URL. But well, I want to launch with the swagger. So replace with the swagger since I'm going to use the HTTPS. I need to use the swagger, and that is all. I've already created a controller which uses or consumes these interfaces that have been created. So from the brand controller, I do have the brand repository over here, and I have all the endpoint associated with it. The same thing applies to category, and also same applies to the product. I'll leave a link to this source code. at GitHub. So check the video description if you want to grab this and review it. It is possible. You can grab it for free. So check it out over there. All right. So let's run this and check it up and see whether this abstract generic repo is working as expected. So we have the endpoint ready in here. Now, when you try one, it works. It tells you that the rest are going to work because they follow the same pattern. Let's see from the brand. So I have already added some data records in here, which takes in the first three. And great, you see, this specific or model specific to this repo is not part of the generic. The generic starts from the post up to delete, right? So let's try to post one and see if this is going to work. We're going to say this is newly added. Click on execute, and of course it has been added. The ID is 13, so we can go for get by ID, pass the ID of 13 and check it out. We're gonna have it. We can also go in there and I'll delete it. So let's update it and see first that the 13, the ID here is 13, and now instead of the newly added, we say newly added updated. Now let's go and hit on execute and let's see. So let's go and get the ID again from this execute, and we see now we have it updated. We can also go in there and delete the same thing. So if I pass in ID of 13, like we see here, it is done. Let's go and get it again and then check it out. 44 not found. You see that? So it tells you that our generic repo is working and we have been able to streamline our code using the generic repo. And no matter how many models that you want to add to your project, you can still base or rely on the generic because it is clean, easy to maintain, adaptable, and it also follows the clean architecture principle. All right, so that is it. Go get it. Get the source code, review it, and I'll try to integrate it in your project. You can let me know in the comment section if you have any issue with it. Aside from that, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, you make sure you do that. And also hit on that bell so you never miss out any of my upcoming tips and tutorials in .NET 9 and 8. Everything. Oh, .NET 9, .NET 8. Yes. All right. So that is it for this video. Thank you so much for watching this. And hopefully I'm going to catch you up again. Till then, take care.